Welcome back everybody to Rust from the Road. Really excited to see you here today. It is Royal Rumble Day. I have loved pro wrestling since the days of the WCW, WWE, Monday Night Wars, or it was WWF at the time, but NWO for life. I really love the Rumble. I think it sets the stage for the whole year, and it's kind of one of the most fun matches.
So I realized after starting this video that some people that are watching may not know what the Royal Rumble is. I figured I'd go over it really quickly. Royal Rumble is a match where 30 superstars enter the ring in timed intervals. The only way to be eliminated is to be thrown over the top rope. So you'll see a lot of things happening with that, and both your feet have to touch the floor. So if only one foot touches, like, it doesn't really count, and you can, like, get back in the ring. Sometimes two people get thrown, like, through the middle and then, like, sneak and hide for the rest of the match. So it's, like, really important to kind of understand how people get eliminated and kind of really listen for that elimination, like the official elimination. Also, the Royal Rumble is known as the Road to WrestleMania because it begins with whoever wins that, they get a championship opportunity to what is known as the grandest stage of them all, WrestleMania. And that's part of why this is such an important match for the beginning of the year.
I was able to host some viewing parties at the sports bar that I worked at, and I met some really great people. And to get introduced to the independent circuit, everyone has to start somewhere, and we're gonna show you some great highlights from some independent wrestlers in this video. I have Kai coming back. She's gonna be doing a little movie review. It's just a really cool day for pro wrestling. If you've never liked pro wrestling, the Royal Rumble is a great way to get introduced to it because you're going to see new faces, you're going to see old faces, you're going to see some sexy faces too. But, you know, it's just a really fun day, and yeah, so let's get into it.
And again, a big thank you to Steve Mesa for these amazing highlights.
Shall we? Now, I will admit, when I was looking at the roster yesterday, I felt like I was looking at the Coachella set list. I really do not know some of these names. I know some of them can be like announcers and, you know, up and coming NXT talent. So not trying to beat myself up about it, but I'm sorry if I don't mention you because I don't know who you are, but I just got my tried and trues, you know? For the men's Royal Rumble, it was incredible to see the amount of talent they have on their current roster. I think it comes down to the last four that I picture in this would be CM Punk, Cody, Gunter, and it's between Kofi and Ricochet. Now, I think Ricochet is kind of a dark horse in these kind of things. Kofi is obviously one of the most entertaining people to watch the Rumble. He gets so creative with like how he doesn't touch his feet, don't touch the floor. I definitely think we're gonna see some stars like Bron Breakker. I still think that we have an opportunity to see some breakout stars like MJF. I got real conspiracy with it too, and I even thought like maybe Kenny Omega's not sick, but again, I don't know contractual obligations. I didn't look that far into it, but you just can't really trust in wrestling. Chad Gable, I love seeing him and Otis, Johnny Gargano, the Usos, Jinder Mahal, the Mysterio family. Bronson Reed I saw was at some media event, so I expect to see him, Tyler Bate, Pete Dunne. The last four in a Rumble, I always think that like it kind of meets certain criteria. You always need at least one big guy. You need at least two people that will team up against that big guy to try to throw him over. And then there's normally some like sneaky little, I'm not gonna use an expletive, but there's always someone sneaking around. So maybe that's like an LA Knight. I know LA Knight and AJ have their match, so I'm not sure if they're gonna be in the Rumble, but I'm so excited for them to bang it out. I'm excited to see R-Truth come out. I don't think he'll know where he is, but we love him so much. My final pick. It's hard. I think the biggest thing that I pictured was CM Punk and Cody getting each other eliminated. Final answer is Cody. I do think they have promised Cody his WrestleMania moment. I would love for Cody to enter in at number one and take it. That would be ideal for me. So, final prediction, Cody wins the men's Royal Rumble match, takes it to WrestleMania, and then fights Roman. Could it be a fatal four-way between him, CM Punk, The Rock, and Roman? Maybe. I do think we're going to get Rock and Roman at the WrestleMania. I think there's no way The Rock bought into TKO without some sort of incentive. All right, so now let's talk about the women's match. The only thing that's going to make me like probably scream cries if Naomi slash Trinity, I don't know what you're gonna call her, but if she comes back and wins it, that is my best case scenario. We know Charlotte's out. I do think we're gonna see some returns like Chelsea Green and Gigi Dolan coming up from the NXT, Dakota Kai, Io. I do think Jade Cargill is gonna do an incredible job in this. You know, we'll have Nia Jax in there. I love Natalya. I think that she's just such a boss and she's been in it for so long. Piper Niven, Raquel, Tamina, I'm sure we'll see. Shayna, Shotzi. Sonya Deville, I do believe, will be in the Rumble. Final four, I had Bayley, Becky, Bianca, and Naomi. If Naomi doesn't come out, say she doesn't win, if she does come out, I do think that Bayley is gonna get it just by what I'm understanding. I don't think she's in a championship mentality right now from what I've seen, but that's never stopped them before. I'm gonna link them down below, but I was able to watch this stream yesterday. A couple of wrestling content creators were doing their predictions. I think they were pretty spot on, especially kicking it with Leo. He kind of opened my eyes to some potential. So I will say my predictions have tweaked a little bit, but it's more like fantasy booking because sometimes you just really want the underdog to win. I love an underdog story. I cry all the time, so.
Speaking of stories, let's head to Hollywood and hear from our maven of the movies.
There are so many professional wrestlers who became actors. And I mean, it makes sense. What they're doing in the ring is very much just live theater. These guys have to have incredible skills and remember choreography, remember storylines, have improvisational skills just in case something does go awry. And it happens more often than you think. The two most famous ones, of course, are The Rock and John Cena, and they've made the transition so flawlessly that that's how they're known. I mean, a lot of people don't even think of them as wrestlers anymore. But when I think of somebody who I really didn't realize was as talented as they were, in a recent movie, I would say it was Dave Bautista, him in Guardians of the Galaxy. I cannot think of another person taking on that role. He's so funny and, you know, the timing is there, the ability is there. He is able to just exist in a scene. He doesn't even have to say anything and it's just so perfect. So I really have to appreciate him for that. And I would say that he's probably my favorite role, you know, in a movie, you know, just thinking of him as, you know, a wrestler prior to that. I don't think that, you know, we give, you know, wrestlers and, you know, athletes even who become actors enough credit. And, you know, it's not that every single one is going to become, you know, some huge, you know, it's going to be the next Rock. I mean, The Rock has been in everything from, you know, Jumanji and Jungle Cruise down to the Tooth Fairy. Did you ever see the Tooth Fairy? It's a little rough. I think John Cena's actually had the better career. But really, I mean, with all of them taking that chance and flexing that muscle and being given the opportunity to show that, you know, they are more than just somebody who can, you know, fling somebody across, you know, what are they, 30-foot rings. Hats off. Hats off to professional wrestlers. They really are performers, and some of them are incredibly well-rounded.
I hope you guys have a wonderful pay-per-view day. I get that pro wrestling is fake to a lot of people, but it's real to our hearts. So don't be judgmental. If you don't like wrestling, that's cool. This probably isn't the video for you. We'll be back and kind of highlighting all kinds of other fun stuff next week that has nothing to do with wrestling. Love you so much. Bye. Welcome back, everybody, to Rust from the Road. Today, I'm really excited to... Oh, goodness, Jessica. I don't know what's happening to you, but we need to... All right. What time is it? 10 a.m. Okay, let's go to Taylor. Welcome back, everybody, and... nope, that ain't it.